I think that the reason that we're seeing this rise in infectious diseases is because our world is getting increasingly more connected, and traveling is now far easier than it was, let's say, 100 years ago or even 50 years ago. So anytime that a new bacterium or a new virus emerges somewhere, within literally months, if not weeks, it can easily get transferred to other parts of the world. And we've seen this with the Ebola virus, where it very quickly becomes not just a local problem, but a global problem. Ultimate goal is try to facilitate the development of new tools for the arms race that we have going on between us as a species and then all the pathogens. So as we invent new drugs, the pathogens that we're fighting with are inventing new ways of getting around them. And so how can we actually understand the way that this happens, and how can we prevent it from happening further? I spend a lot of time studying the specific connections between mutations and resistance to specific drugs. I also develop computational models that can tell us about the particular effects that more tailored drug regimens might have on the overall trajectory of the infectious disease. Genomes are very large. They contain a huge number of nucleotides, but there's no way that you can analyze the data by hand. So you need both mathematical models and computational algorithms. I think that the way that big data can help us defend from the attacks of bacteria and viruses is by providing us with a sufficient number of data points to actually understand the way that resistance emerges, the way that these pathogens evolve, and the way that we can fight against